Wow, what do you know? It's time for the Pocket Knife Show.
Hey, it's Mike on the mic again for another episode of the Pocket Knife Podcast. Exactly 365 days before the release of this episode, my dad died. He breathed his last breath at 4:25 a.m. My sister and her husband arrived at Hilltop Manor, the nursing home he'd been living in, at 4:35. My mom and I pulled into the parking lot 2 minutes later. The staff at Hilltop were so kind. They cleaned Dad up and situated him in his bed before allowing us to enter his room. Once we were inside, they made sure we were afforded privacy. They spoke lovingly to my mom. They all knew her. She'd been visiting Dad daily for 2 months. They called the funeral home for us. There was nothing we had to concern ourselves with beyond grieving. After Dad's body was picked up by our friends at Larrison's, all of us went out to eat at Dos Palominos. The owner's granddaughter was hanging out with her that morning. She kept us relaxed and entertained while we waited for our food. We chuckled quietly when we overheard this young one asking an amputee across the room about where his arm was. He handled her inquisitiveness well. Breakfast was delicious. We enjoyed it as we began talking about what we had to do in the coming days. We divvied up the list of relatives who needed to know of Dad's passing. Our meal done and paid for, we drove back to the nursing home to collect Dad's stuff to take home. The excellent care continued as more and more staff members consoled Mom and the rest of us. Because we had a family wedding to tend to over the weekend and lots of other details to nail down, Dad's memorial service was put off till the end of the month. Most of the family was able to attend. We enjoyed a private family burial in the cemetery before the service at the church. Many people, friends and family, spoke of my dad's love for Jesus, his faithfulness to God's word, and his fervent prayers. When the final prayer was spoken, we headed to the basement for a lunch prepared lovingly by women from our Pratt Church family. Over the next day or so, our family had great conversations about the blessings we enjoyed because of the man who was no longer with us. Then, one by one, families headed for home. Otley, Commerce City, Kingman. We've gotten together almost every week since then via Zoom. Early on, our video chats were about death certificates and life insurance policies and changing names on bank accounts. Eventually, though, most of those details were managed, and we settled into a we are family and love spending time together rhythm. Over the past 365 days, I can't tell you how many times I've cried. Weird things have set me off. I wept walking up the sidewalk to the church once. I guess I was remembering my dad's faithfulness to preach God's word. At Christmas, Dad was greatly missed. At least he didn't get sick with the rest of us. On his birthday, early in February, everyone on Facebook was wishing Mom a happy birthday. I'd changed the name on her profile shortly after Dad had passed, but hadn't thought to update the birth date. I got a bit choked up over that. Until early this year, I continued receiving emails from Charles Neifert. When I went in to correct that detail, I found Mom's birth date was on the account. How had one item been changed and not the other? To close out this episode, I want to share a song with you from Dad's memorial service. The family, those who wanted to, sang it together because it was a song Dad loved, a worship chorus which honored Jesus. Even in the late stages of dementia, Dad knew and loved his Savior. More than once, he urged me or one of my kids or his wife to believe on the Lord Jesus Christ and be saved. What an awesome finish to a well-lived life, a life which brought glory to the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords.